Good afternoon, grade sixes. Today we are having a lesson on English. We are going to have an English lesson today. Okay, Thabo? All right. We are going to talk about writing a formal letter. Writing a formal letter. How to write a formal letter? Formal, F-O-R-M-A-L. F-O-R-M-A-L. A formal letter. A formal letter can be known as a business letter, where you are asked to write to someone else that you don't know. Okay, you might be asked to write a letter to the principal asking her for something, or you might be asked to write a letter to a certain shop. Maybe let's say you bought something from Pick and Pay, and whatever you bought was not, maybe mommy bought a microwave and it's already broken, okay? She bought it yesterday and today is no longer functioning. You might be asked to write a letter to the manager to tell them about your problem, okay? So that is a business letter, okay? You are writing to someone that you don't know, or you can be writing to someone that you know, but still when it is a business letter, it means that it's a letter that has to be straight to the point. You're not asking how they are doing. You're not asking if they ate breakfast. You're not asking whether or if they ate supper yesterday. You are talking business with them. Whatever you want to tell them, you tell them straight and you go straight to the point. Okay. So the first thing we need to talk about when I talk about a formal letter, let's take the point down that it is called a business letter. A formal letter, it is called a business letter. Someone, you can have a question where they say, compile a business letter to a teacher, to a principal, to a manager, or you can write an application letter. Since you are grade sixes, you should be starting to apply. You can write an application letter to a certain school that you want to go to or something. So that is a form of a business letter. I'm not sure whether you're still applying. When we used to learn, we used to write application letters to schools. Okay, so those are types of business letters. Okay, also with the formal letter, you compile your things, they are all straight to the point. The moment you say, I am writing this letter, you go straight to the point. I am writing this letter to ask for permission for this. I am writing this letter to inform you about this. I am writing this letter to tell you about this. Okay, you are not asking anything. You are just going straight to the point. Do you understand, Thabo?
Yes.
Okay, so you already tell your story when you're writing. I am writing this letter to inform you or to ask, to seek for permission for this. And also a formal letter has two addresses. It has two addresses. Okay, one address belongs to the school. Okay, whenever we are writing a letter, okay, the address that we need to see first must be the school address. Okay, if you are writing in an exam, they say write a formal letter, don't use your home address, use the school address. I'll tell you where you may use your home address. But when we are writing a formal letter, we mostly use our school address. So you must know how to write our school address. We're going to make sure we find time so that we can combine our own formal letter so that we can revisit our school address. Okay? All right. The first address you said is the school address, and the other address, it must belong to the receiver, okay? Whoever you are writing to. If you are writing to Pick and Pay, you must know the address for Pick and Pay. If you are writing it to the school head of a certain other school, you must know the address for that school head. So you must make sure your addresses, you must know them. We're going to talk about how to write an address. Tyrone Spenton, welcome. Can you hear me? Tyrone, are you able to
connect? Good
morning, how are you, Tyrone? Welcome to today's English lesson. We are talking about writing a formal letter. we're talking about writing a formal letter. We've already written points that it is a business letter. It is formal meanings, everything you talk about. You talk about formal things. Even the language is formal as well, okay? You don't say, hi, how are you doing? I hope you're doing great. How's it? What's going on? We don't use that type of language. You use formal language. Good morning, ma'am. Good afternoon. You GSA or madam, we are using formal language as well when we are writing. Okay, imagine you are writing to the head of Falcon where you want to go to formal. You are saying, how are you doing? I hope you're keeping fine. How's everything moving? Already that letter is going to be torn and thrown in the bin. Okay, because she can tell that you are not a good person. She might not even want to read your letter because people don't really have time to be reading a lot of letters. There'll be a lot of letters for that head to read. And if your letter already has mistakes, she's going to throw it in the bin. She won't even want to know or hear anything about you. So you have to make sure you use respectful language. Okay. And also when we are writing a letter, we must observe the skipping of lines. We skip lines. We are going to write our own letters together. I hope you have a paper there, Tabo. Please, may you open on a fresh, clean page. Open a fresh, clean page. Tyrone, please, can you try to do something about your video so that I can assist you as you are writing your formal letter? Okay. So before we start writing our formal letter, this is the letter that we are going to practice writing together. Okay. Let's take this down. It says, you know that you are going to be absent from school. You know that you are going to be absent from school. Just take that down. Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
That's better. Shadrick, we are having a lesson on writing a formal letter, a business letter, okay? We want to start writing our letter, so please take down the practice letter that we're going to write. It says, you know that you are going to be absent from school. You know that you are going to be absent from school. You know that you are going to be absent from school for the next 2 or 3 days, full stop. You know that you are going to be absent from school for the next 2 or 3 days, full stop. You know that you are going to be absent from school for the next 2 or 3 days, full stop. That's better, Tyrone. You know that you are going to be absent from school for the next 2 or 3 days. Write a formal or business letter to your teacher. Write a formal or business letter to your teacher. Write a formal or business letter to your teacher, telling him about your absence. Telling him about your absence. You know that you're going to be absent from school for the next 2 or 3 days. Full stop. Write a formal or business letter to your teacher, telling him about your absence. Absence is absence. Telling him about your absence. Full stop. The body of your letter should be 80 to 120 words in length. The body of your letter should be 80 to 120 words in length, which means this is the required number, okay? This is the required number, number of words. You can write it within 80 to 120 words, or you can also talk about it. It must cover a page, okay? At least a page, one page. That is enough. A page is enough. And remember, for the letter, already the 80 to 120 words, the addresses, we count the words as well, okay? So that's the good thing about the letter as well. That's why we always want to teach you guys to write a letter It's easier. And the letter contains a lot of free marks, marks for the addresses, marks for the salutation, marks. There are so many free marks there that you are given for free. So if you know that you are not good in narrating compositions, you can look for a letter and write an informal business letter. It is much easier. It doesn't have a lot of information as well because you are writing straight to the point. Okay, you don't have to meander and talk about a lot of things. Okay, the points that we are going to use to write that letter are, the first point, you write that you are sorry that you are going to be absent from school. That's the first point that is going to help you to write the letter, that you are sorry you are going to be absent from school. So as you are writing this letter to your teacher, you must write and apologize. You must write and apologize that you are going to be absent from school, okay? That you are going to be absent from school. So you write that you are sorry that you are going to be absent from school. The second point that you are going to use is, you are writing the letter, where you will be, where you will be, and what you will be doing, okay? Now you are explaining to the teacher, I'm going to be absent for the next 2 to 3 days because I am going, okay? Where you will be, okay? You cannot just be absent just to sit home and laze around and watch the TV. There must be a good reason where you will be. Maybe you are going to a doctor's, maybe you have a doctor's appointment, or maybe you are going to visit a relative who is not feeling well, or maybe you are going to do something, maybe you have a problem with your documents and you are going to get them fixed or something like that. You must have a concrete reason about where you will be and what you will be doing, okay? Where you will be and what you will be doing. Where you will be and what you will be doing. And your third point is, you ask your teacher to send you some homework. Ask your teacher to send you some homework. The reason why you are writing this letter, inform your teacher that you are sorry, you apologize to your teacher. I'm sorry, teacher, I will be absent for the next 2 to 3 days. This is because I am going to be at this place and I'm going to be doing this and this. That's why I will be absent. And also, you are going to ask your teacher to send you some homework, okay? You are going to ask your teacher that during those 2 to 3 days that you are going to be absent, may you kindly send me homework as I am writing, so that I can be writing, okay? So you are asking your teacher to send you some homework. Now, may you get your paper and pen. Can you open a fresh, clean page? When we are writing a letter, whether informal, business letter, or it is a friendly letter, we use a fresh page. We use a fresh page. Okay. We said, how many addresses do we have in a business letter? How many addresses do we have in a business letter or a formal letter? Yes, Thabo?
We have two letters.
We have two addresses. Two addresses. Thank you, Thabo. Some people, usually they fold their paper when they are writing a letter so that to try and, you see, you can fold it into a half. Why? Because remember, you are writing a business letter. You want your address to be straight, okay? You want everything to be straight. So we are going to use the right side of your paper. Can you look at your right side? Your right, I think our rights are the same. Yes, the right side of your paper, the top right, they're at the top. That's where we're going to have this letter. You're writing it to a teacher. So already, the address that you're going to put there is your home address. So Thabo, I'm going to start with you. What is your home address? May you kindly give us your home address. Yes, Thabo?
7 Baptist Lane.
Sorry?
My home address is 7 Baptist Lane.
7?
Baptist Lane, then side door.
Okay, good. So 7, you said Baptist Lane, then side. Okay, so the 7 will come at the top, and then you come to the bend side below, and then Blawayo underneath. Okay, so you're going to use 3 lines there. Okay? Are we together, Thabo? You can start writing your address there. Then you will show me, you just show me on the camera there. Tyrone, may I please have your address, your home address? What is your home address?
16 Chopping Road. 16 Chopping Road.
Tyrone, may you
16 Chopping Road.
Mm-hmm.
The Baham Green.
Baham Green, okay. So you have your 17 there at the top, then your Baham Green coming below, then your Blawayo there. So we are also going to use our three lines there, okay? So we are going to start there at the top. It should be your right side. You have already folded, right? So since you have folded, this fold here, that's where you're going to start writing so that everything is straight there, okay? And when we're writing the address, we don't skip a line there, okay? Your address one comes after the other and then the next. We're going to skip when we are going to the next stage, okay? So we can start writing. Let us start practicing. Practice writing your address. I'm going to try and write mine here as well so that we are doing it together. Okay, are we done? I can see Thabo is still writing. I've already done my own address here. So you see, I was using my right corner there. Okay, can you see there, Tyrone? So you see when I have folded there, can you see all the letters must start here with where you folded there? Can you see there? It makes it straight, the folding there. If you can estimate with your eyes, well, you can use it. But the problem is when you don't, you can find that your things won't be straight, but the moment you fold, it makes it easier for you when you are writing there, okay? You know that there's that straight line, that's the one that you are following, so that everything is straight. And you're given marks for just writing your own address, okay? A mark is given to you, so make sure that when you're writing your letter, everything of yours is on point there, okay? As you are writing, so you don't skip a line. When you are writing your full, you write your full address without skipping. You're going to skip a line when we are going to write the date, okay? But for now, we are not skipping a line. Thabo, are we together?
Yes.
I think Shadrick's network, he has disappeared. I'm sure he will come back in. Have we all managed to write our addresses? I think we're looking for Thabo. Thabo, when you are done, please tell us so that we can go to the next stage. At least we are able to do this stage, and then when you get home, you can finish writing your letter. That will be okay, because I want us to get this address thing right, okay? Letters are very easy, right? As long as if you know how to write your addresses and everything is on point, okay? Right. Okay, can we move on? So after this, you can skip a line. After you've written your address, you skip one line, okay? Skip a line. We are still on that side, okay? We skip a line. Unfortunately, my paper is burnt. I don't have lines, but I've drawn a line there. If you can see it, I've drawn a line there. So you skip a line. When we skip a line, we write the date. What is today's date?
July.
It's July. It's July 2020. So you don't write the date. Okay? We leave the date. We leave out the month. We just write 6 July 2020. Let's write that. 6 July. 6 July 2020.
We skip a line, huh?
Yes, you skip a line, yes. And you after Blawayo, you skip a line, then you write 6 July 2020. Are we together, Thabo?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Thabo, good. Yes, that is proper, Thabo. So your other side is space there. Okay, you leave that space. Don't worry about it. We leave it. So now that we have the 6 July 2020, let's skip a line again. Let us skip a line. Okay. Okay, we have, let's keep our line. Now we come back to the left side, okay? Now we are coming back to our left side, right? You have skipped a line there, right? Now we come back to this side. We want to write our second address. You are writing to your teacher, right? I am at Destiny Learning Center. So that is our second address. Our second address is going to be Destiny Learning Center. Okay, who can remind us our address? Anyone who can remind us our
8 Manchester Road.
8 Manchester Road. Belmont.
Belmont.
Ohio. It uses 4 lines, okay? So we have Destiny Learning Center, number 8 Manchester Road, Belmont, Blawayo. Okay? Did you manage to get that? So we are going to use 4 lines, okay? So the first line, now we are on this side. Are we together, Tabo?
Yes.
Yes.
So now we are going to the other side, okay? The left side, okay? So you have skipped the line, you go to the left side. You don't go at the top there, you're going below there, okay? Where they where you've skipped the line, you start writing
below
the learning center. Here, Tyrone. Here.
Okay. And then you write Destiny Learning Center in one line.
There. Yes. So the first line, Destiny Learning Center. That is our first line. Destiny Learning Center. Destiny Learning Center, then number 8, remember the number we write N and an O, right? Number 8, Manchester Road. The road, let's write road in full. Number 8, Manchester Road, right? The road.
Spelling of Manchester.
Manchester, M-A-N-C-H. The Manchester, you know the team, Manchester, that's the one. M-A-N-C-H-E-S-T-E-R, Manchester Road. Number 8, Manchester Road. Then we come down, Belmont. Belmont is B-E-L-M-O-N-T. Belmont, there's a T at the end, it's not a D, it's a T. Belmont, B-E-L-M-O-N-T. Belmont, and then after Belmont, Blawayo. So we are going to use 4 lines there. Don't skip a line, just one after the other, okay? Have we written?
Done.
You're done?
Yes.
So at the end, you have something like this now. You have your address there. You have the date there, you skip the line, you have the other address here, okay? The Destiny Learning Center one. Now, we are going to skip a line. We are now using this left side where there is the Destiny Learning Center. You skip a line, then you write DSA or Madam. Remember, we are writing a formal business letter, right? So here, you are writing to your teacher, right? So since you know your teacher, well, you're saying, dear Mrs. Mloja, so you just write, dear Mrs. Mloja. If you don't know the person whom you're writing to, that's why you can say, dear sir or madam. Okay? Are we together? This business letter you're writing to your teacher, right? So you know your teacher. Okay? So you say, dear Mrs. Mloja. If it's Mrs. Mloja, dear Mr. Okay? You use, if you know the person, if you know the teacher, you know that person, just say, okay, do you understand? But let's say you are writing to a shop, a certain manager or a certain headmistress from another school. You don't know whether it's a headmistress or it's a headmaster. You can say DSA or Madam. Or you're writing to a manager at a certain company. You don't know. If you just say DSA, what if the manager is a lady? She will be offended to see you writing DSA. Okay, so you say DSA or Madam. Okay, so here we skip a line again. The skipping of lines must be maintained. It's one of the key features of a letter where we move around skipping our lines. So here you say, dear Mrs. Lojo. Okay, dear Mrs. Lojo. unfortunately, we have come to the end of our lesson. It's now time off. I want you to go and finish off that letter, okay? I've already given you how we set up our letter, our two addresses, how we put our next address, and then you have DM Mrs. Mlojwa, your teacher. And then at the end, you are going to, when you have written, when you start writing the letter, you say, I am writing this letter to inform, to apologize that I am going to be absent from school. Okay, because it's an apologetic letter that you are writing. And you tell me I am going to be absent from school because I'm going to be doing this, I'll be here and there. You know where you're going to be. You look at a place where you're going to be. And then I'm kindly asking you, teacher, if you can send me some homework, okay? And at the end, you say, yours sincerely, you write your name and your surname, okay? You write both your name and your surname. Did we understand how we're going to finish off our letter, Thabo?
Yes.
Tyron, did you understand as well how we're going to finish off our letter?
Yes.
Tyron?
Yes.
Okay, so I have sent the same letter to you as homework. Please go and finish it, okay? And then you can submit your work, okay? Thank you for participating in today's lesson on writing a business letter. Remember, business letter is all the requirements that you need to follow. Let me give you a chance to say goodbye to one another before we end our lesson for today. So bye.
Bye, teacher. Bye.
Bye, Tyron. Have a nice day. See you again tomorrow at the same time, okay? Bye.